Dear students, in practical number 3, we have to write an assembly language program for 8051 microcontroller to perform arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. For this purpose, we will use Keil Microvision 5th version. We will develop the program in Keil, we will assemble the program and we will simulate the program in Keil itself. Before writing the program, let's find what steps I need to follow in order to write the program, and this stepwise step procedure is also called as algorithm. First, I have to move the first number in accumulator. I want to make the addition of 2 and 3, so I will move 02 to the accumulator and then I will add 03 with it, and the result of addition will be stored in accumulator. Then in third step, I will move the content of accumulator to R0. In short, result of addition will be stored in R0 register. Then clear the accumulator. Next, I want to perform the subtraction. So for that purpose, I will move 05H in accumulator. Then I will subtract the content of accumulator and 02H. After subtraction, result will be in accumulator and I will move the result in R1. So, result of subtraction will be stored in R1. In next step, clear the accumulator content and clear the carry flag. Now, I want to perform the multiplication. I want to multiply 03H and 02H. So, 03H will be moved into accumulator, 02 will be moved into register B. Then, in the next step, I will multiply these two numbers. And once multiplication is performed, I will store the result. As multiplication will give me 16-bit result, I will store the product in R2 as well as R3 register. Then I will clear the accumulator. And final step is I want to divide two numbers. 95H is to be divided by 10H. So I will move them in register A and B respectively. I will perform the division by using DIV instruction, and division will give me the result in the form of quotient and remainder. So I will store the quotient in R4 register and I will store the result remainder in R5 register. Now let us actually do the programming part. So for programming, double click the Keil Microvision 5th version. The Keil environment gets opened. First you have to create the project. So for creating the project, click project and click Microvision project. This window gets opened. Now locate the folder where you want to save the project. I have to save the project in E drive under the folder 8051 programs. Now I will name the project as arithmetic. So once you name the project, click the save button. Another window pops up which asks you to choose the microcontroller for which you are doing the programming. I am doing the programming for Atmel 8089S51 microcontroller. Depending on your requirement, depending on the device you are using, you can choose any other microcontroller also. So I will locate 8089S51 series of controller and then I will click OK. This message will ask you whether you want to copy startup.a51 to project folder. It is necessary to copy for C language programming, but as I am performing the programming in assembly language, I will click no. So you are done with creating the project whose name is arithmetic. Now it's time to create a file. So for that purpose, click file and then click new. So this editor window gets open where you can type the program. Before typing the program, I will advise you to save this file. So click the save button. Ensure that you are saving the program in the same folder where you have saved the project. So I will save the project. I will in the same folder, I will name the program as arithmetic, but I will put the extension .asm because this program is written in in assembly language. So arithmetic. Just let me correct the spelling. So, arithmetic.asm is the name of the program. So once the program is saved, the next important step is you have to include this program, or you have to make this program as a part of the project. So for that purpose, right click the source group one and click on add existing files to group. Here files of type, select ASM source file so that ASM file is visible. The file which I have just saved is arithmetic.asm. Click the name, click the add button, click close, and cross check, cross verify whether it is really added or not. So it has added under the project. So once you are done with this part, now start writing the program. So first directive is org 000. It will tell the assembler that I want to start writing the program, I want to start storing the program from memory location 0000h. The next thing is load the first number in accumulator. As I want to perform the addition of 02 and 03, I will load first number, that is 02h, in accumulator. Next thing is I want to add this number which is in accumulator with the second number, that is 03h. So add a comma hash 03h. So this instruction will add content of a, that is 02 with 03. So 02h is added with 03h, 05h will be the result, and that result will be stored in accumulator. I want to have that result in register R0. So I will move the content of accumulator to R0 by writing the instruction move R0 comma A. And instead of writing the whole program, I will just write the end. So we will develop the program block by block. We will first verify addition program, then we will go for subtraction program, then we will go for multiplication program, and finally we will perform the division program. Once you are done with it, click the save button and click the build target and check whether your program contains any error or not. Fortunately, my program is error free. As I am not using the hardware, so there is no necessity of going for option port target, but I will tell you how to enter the crystal frequency. The crystal frequency is 0.11592. Click on use on chip ROM, then go to the output and click on create XPI and click OK. So this additional step is required only when you are performing the practical either in Proteus simulation software or you are performing the practical on actual hardware. Again save it and build target. Now it's time to simulate the program. The first step is click debug and click on start stop debug session. Click OK. This window gets open. On the left hand side, you will find that various registers are there, and you have to check the result in R0. So you have to observe the output here. In order to observe the output, I have to execute the program. So I will go to the debug and then I will click run button. And now you can view that R0 register contains 05H. So I have cross checked that 02 when added with 03 will give me 05 as a result, and from accumulator it is shifted to 05. So I am done with the addition part. So again click the debug menu and click on start stop debug session so as to come out of the debug. Next step is to perform the subtraction. Before performing the subtraction, I will clear the content of accumulator because I am going to use the accumulator in subtraction instruction also. So I will clear the accumulator. I will also clear the carry flag, and then I will start writing the code for subtraction. I want to subtract 02H from 05H. So first number is to be loaded in accumulator. First number is 05H. So I will load 05H in accumulator. Then subtraction can be performed by using SUBB instruction. SUBB is followed by subtrahend, means the number from which you want to subtract, it is the 05 and which is in accumulator. So I have written a comma minus end, means which number you want to subtract from 05. I want to subtract 02h from 05, so I have written hash 02h. So it will perform a minus 02h, or it will perform 05H minus 02H and it will save the result in accumulator. But I want to shift that result, or I want to move that result in resistor R1. So I will write move R1 comma A, so that result of subtraction is shifted to R1. So as subtraction coding is done, I will save the program, I will click the build target, and I will check whether this additional code has generated any errors or not. There are no errors. Now I can check the result. For that, you have to go to the debug menu and click the start stop debug session. Once you click the start stop debug session, you are in a debug mode. Now where you will observe the output? You will observe the output in R1 register. Now let us run the program. So debug and run. Now you can see here that R1's content are 03, because 05 number and 02 number, these two numbers, they are subtracted, means 02 is subtracted from 05, so it will obviously give you 03 as the output, and it is shifted to the R1 register by using this instruction. So, and previously when we perform addition, we shifted the result of addition to R0, so it is also visible here. So addition result 05 is in R0 register, and subtraction part, result of subtraction, that is 03, it is in R1. Now let us come out of the debug session. You can come out of the debug session by clicking debug and start of debug session, or alternatively here you will find the icon for stopping the debug session. So you can follow either of the method. Now it's time to write the code for performing the multiplication of two numbers. I want to multiply 03H and 04H. So first number, that is multiplicand, is to be loaded into accumulator. So I have written the instruction move A comma hash 03H. This will load, or this will move 03H into accumulator. For multiplication, one thing you should remember, that first number should be in accumulator and second number, that is multiplier, it should be in register B. So I have to compulsorily move the second number into register B. So I will write move B comma hash 04H. So first number 03H, that is multiplicand, is in A. Second number multiplier, that is 04H, it is in B. In short, what I want to do is I want to multiply the number in accumulator with number in register B. And which instruction is there for multiplication? A single instruction, the only one instruction which performs multiplication, is MULAB. This instruction will multiply the content of register A and content of register B. It will produce 16-bit result, and out of those 16-bit, lower order 8 bits will be stored in accumulator. So I will move lower order result from accumulator to register R2. So lower order 8 bits of result are moved to R2. Similarly, higher order 8 bits of multiplication result, they are now in register B, and I want to have them in R3 register. So I will write move R3 comma B. So remember these steps, that multiplication will give you 16 bit result. So this 16 bit, but these registers are 8 bit in nature. So lower order 8 bits are moved from A to R2. Similarly, higher order 8 bits of result are in B, and they are shifted to register R3. Now save the program again, click the build target, program contains no error. Now start debugging. Debug, start stop debug session, click OK. Now what is the expected result? Which numbers I have multiplied? I have multiplied 03 by 04. 03H, it is a hexadecimal number. 04H, again it is a hexadecimal number. In decimal, 03 is same as 03. 04H is same, that is 04 in decimal. So 3 into 4 comes to be 12, but our result will be displayed in hexadecimal form. and it is 0C because 12 is called as a 0C in hexadecimal. And lower order part, that is 0C, is in accumulator and it will be shifted into R2 register. Similarly, the higher order part of result is 00 because I have multiplied the two numbers which are very small. So higher order 8 bits will be obviously 0. Higher order result is stored in D. So this result D will be shifted, this result which is now in D will be shifted into R3. So higher order result will be 00 and lower order result will be 12, which is shifted in R2. Now I will run the program. So debug, run. Now we can view here that R2 holds the value 0C. So lower order result, that is 0C, is shifted into R2. And higher order result, which is 0, can be seen in R3 register. So multiplication is done and result is cross-checked by observing the values in register R2 and R3. So stop the debug session. Now the last part of the program. I have to perform the multiplication of two numbers. You can write clear A also here, otherwise it will get overwritten. Now the next part is performing the subtraction. The dividend or the number in numerator is 95H. So I will move 95H to accumulator. Then this 95H is to be divided by 10H. As in multiplication, the first number was in accumulator and second was in register B. Same rule applies here. For performing the division, you should have first number in accumulator and the second number, that is divisor, it should be compulsorily be in register B. So move the second number, that is 10H, into register B. So 95H divided by 10H. The result will be in the form of quotient and remainder. Remember this, that whenever we perform division, and how division is performed? Division is performed by writing the instruction DIVAB. So this instruction will perform A divided by B operation. The result will be in the form of quotient and remainder. Quotient will be in register A. After execution of this instruction, quotient will be stored in register A and remainder will be stored in register B. I want to move the quotient from register A to R4 register. So what I will write? I will write move R4 comma A. So quotient part of result which is in A is now shifted to R4 register. Similarly, the remainder is to be shifted into R5 register. So the result of division will be in the form of quotient and remainder. Quotient which is in A is moved to R4 register. Remainder which is now in B is moved to R5 register. So in short, R4 and R5 will display quotient and remainder respectively. Can you guess what will be the quotient and what will be the remainder after execution of this instruction? Orally it is little bit of hard to calculate. So what we will do, we will perform the calculation. Now dividend, the first number is 95H. So we are acquainted with the calculation in decimal. So we will convert first number 95H into decimal. So 9 into 16 raised to 1 plus 5 into 16 raised to 0. 16 raised to 1 is equal to 16. So 9 into 16 plus 16 raised to 0 is 1. So 9 into 16 plus 5 into 1. 9 into 16 is 144. 5 into 1 is 5. So 95H correspond to 149 in decimal. Similarly, second number, that is divisor, it is 10H. And 10H is to be converted into decimal. How to convert it? Write it in the form of 1 into 16 raised to 1 plus 0 into 16 raised to 0. It comes to be 1 into 16 plus 0 into 1 and it is 16 plus 0, which is 16. In short, 149 is to be divided by 16. So when 149 is divided by 16, Instead of calculating the result in fractional, calculate the result in the form of quotient and remainder. So when I divide 149 by 16, 16 nines are 144. So quotient is 9, and 149 minus 144 is 5. So remainder is 5. So my result is quotient is 9 and remainder is 5. 9 in decimal is called as 9 in hexadecimal. Remainder is 5. 5 in decimal is same. That is 05H in hexadecimal. So I should get the result 09H and 05H in register R4 and R5 respectively. So let us check it. So let us go to the kill part. Save the program. Build the target. There are no errors. Now debug the program. Debug. Start stop debug session. Click OK. And now it's time to run the program. So debug and run. Now you can see that R4 contains 09H, which is the quotient, and R5 contains 05H, which is the remainder. Thus, we have verified that the quotient and remainder which we have obtained through program is same that of which we just calculated, and thus we have performed the program for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now we can stop debugging session by pressing this key. So hope you have understood how to perform, how to write a program, how to simulate the program by using kill, and how to observe the result. Thank you. Thank you very much.